All right. Let's get this whole area cleaned up.
We'll be right back.
All right, we just need antifreeze, a battery, an oil filter, oil, hydraulic fluid. We'll be ready to fire this dude up. All right, so we're on the low side. All right, I'm gonna drain the rest of the fluids and see if we can get after it here. About 2.5 gallon. All right, so one of these strokes is about 9 ounces. Thank you. was it. All right, she's full. This wire here, I guess this should take a minute and explain why I'm doing this. This wire here, if you look at it, there we go. If you look at it there, see that green? See, that's not good. That's not good. And it just goes on. So, yeah. Some of that wire is still good, but it's got a lot of corrosion in it, and you're gonna lose conductivity through this copper because of that. So for that reason, I'm replacing this starter wire coming from the battery. All right, we've got it hooked up here. I got it run up through here and ran over to the battery. It didn't arc when I put it on. That's a good sign, I guess. All right. Well, I've been messing with this electric system off camera. I was just trying to chase out the problem and found the problem. It's a fuse. Fuse in the dash. I had one good fuse, I got one bad fuse. I'll stop and get some them old-timey bus fuses. You know, like this. The old tube fuse. This one's blown. That was for the starter. And now that I know that, I'll go get some good fuses and keep them in the tractor. Now, why the starter fuse is blown, I don't know. But it is. And so we'll replace it and go from there. So that fixes the electrical problems. Well, they weren't problems. It was just a blown fuse. So far as I know, most of the lights work on the front. I'm not going to be running this thing down the road. I'm not too concerned about that. Headlights working is kind of nice, you know, for working after dark, which I very clearly do. However, I got a new starter cable run from the battery back to the starter, which that was important. That's done. And so now I just got to put hydraulic fluid and everything and put some diesel in it and see if this dude busts off. And so that's how close we are. I'm very excited. So, all right, saying that, let's get some hydraulic fluid pumped. We need to get this plug out here so we can pour the hydraulic fluid in there. And then the dipstick is right there. Yep, right there. All right, let's get it filled. Thank you. All right. That shows to be a little over full, but I also don't have any in my filter. All right, power steering. There we go. And it barely does fit, but it fits. That's what matters. I've already used quite a bit of this. Blip again. It must be full. Yep. See, it's full. Nope. All right. I got it. All right, now we're right here. This looks good. All right, I got diesel running out there. I know I got diesel to here. So now what? And it's wet looking right there. I'm gonna cinch them two up. All I've been doing is just sitting here pumping that manual pump on that other side. That's all I've been doing. Oh, that's not decent. That's got fluid. All right, everything's tight. See if you start. All the air out of the lines yet. Keep working at it. Alright, well, here's where we're at. I think it's time to try some starting fluid. I've seen wet up here on all these injector lines. So we're gonna hit it with a little starting fluid, see if that does anything. Go. Start a fluid in the air cleaner. Here we go. She hit. She almost stayed running that time. We might be getting somewhere. Let's try it again.